Good evening and welcome to Legacy Hall. At this time, please silence all cell phones or any other noise-making device. If you must leave, please do so in between pieces or during the applause. Lastly, the use of any audio or video recording is strictly prohibited. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you, and thank you for coming out to my recital tonight here at Columbus State University. My name is Denson Paul Pollard. I'm a member of the Metropolitan Opera Orchestra, and I also teach at Indiana University. This is my collaborator, Dr. Joanne Chang. Give her a hand. She's going to play a lot of notes tonight, let me tell you. I am currently on sabbatical at Indiana University. Really great thing we have going there. And as my sabbatical project, one of the things that I'm doing is traveling to various places and playing repertoire that represents a really broad and diverse slice of the different composers that are available to our instrument. Some of these pieces you may have heard that I'm going to play for you tonight, but I can almost guarantee you there are a couple that you've never heard of. And we're going to begin the recital tonight with a piece that was commissioned by a group of bass trombone players, including myself. It was led by my good friend James Markey from the Boston Symphony Orchestra. He befriended Kevin Day and asked him to write a piece for bass trombone and piano. And the Fantasia 4 was the result of that request. Kevin Day is a very interesting guy. He is, I don't think he's even 30 years old yet, and he's already composed almost 200 compositions, which is remarkable. You know, some people go their whole lives without composing 200 pieces. And he grew up in a household where he was listening to R&B and hip-hop and gospel simultaneously because his father was a hip-hop producer and his mother was a professional gospel singer. And when you combine that with his activities in high school band and marching band and pep band and all the things that you do as a high school band person, you get music like you're going to hear now. So this is Fantasia 4 by Kevin Day. Thank you. Thank you very kindly. That's a really fun piece to play, filled with landmines here and there, but a great composition for bass trombone for sure. Now, our next piece on the program again is the result of the output of another very interesting woman named Rena Esmail, E-S-M-A-I-L, and Rena is Hindu American and is Hindu by religion. Grown up listening to the ragas that are used for worship in her religion. And she was in school with a colleague of mine, Britt Lash, who also teaches at Indiana University at Yale. And they were there during COVID. And Rena and Britt started talking about a possible composition for bass trombone that had the influences of Rena's background. And this is what happened as a result of that. And as Rena says, the tone and mood of this music was the result of the fact that she felt so isolated and so alone oftentimes during COVID, and she lost the ability to communicate in a way, in an open and honest way that she had pre-COVID. And so this is a very honest and open and vulnerable piece for her. So this is the Esmail Sonata for trombone.
Thank you. So this is a Fantasia by Manuel Matarita. days we've been on the road doing various things, and this music is really breathing and taking on a life of its own, and each night it's a little bit different. So it's really fun to play multiple recitals of the same song and to see that happen. Let's say goodbye to her for a moment. And our next piece is a duet with a current student here at Columbus State University. And he's probably back there waiting for his introduction. Chris Bassett is a phenom, really. He's one of the very successful young bass trombone players in the world today. He won multiple jobs and is currently the bass trombonist of the San Francisco Symphony Orchestra and finishing up his master's degree here at Columbus State University. We're going to play a duet for you that was written by, someone that I really truly think is unique in the world, Daniela Candelari. Her real name is Daniela Zusic, is her real name. She was born in Serbia in the middle of a civil war to parents who were Olympic athletes. Her mother carried the torch in an Olympics for Serbia. Her mother was an Olympic ping pong player, and her father was an Olympic pole vaulter, and she wound up not being an athlete somehow and fell in love with music, got to America, no Chris,
hey.
was a Fulbright scholar to come to America, Indiana University, where I teach, as a jazz pianist. She was a jazz pianist in the beginning and was just one of those people that just tried to learn as much as she could in every environment that she's in. And since coming to America, besides being a great composer, she's also a very accomplished pianist. And she is now a very accomplished conductor. She's the music director of the St. Louis Opera, and also the opera director at Music Academy of the West in Santa Barbara. But she's married to a bass trombone player, Nick Schwartz. She's the bass trombonist of the New York City Ballet. And Nick and his buddy Sebastian, who run the Third Coast Trombone Retreat, asked her to write a duet for them. And that's how Balkanica came about. You're going to hear strong influence of Balkan brass band music. And when I was told about this, I had no idea what it was, but I immediately went to YouTube and I did a search for Balkan brass band. And it's some of the most visceral, energetic music you're going to hear. I mean, imagine like a marching band in the stands on steroids. I don't know how their instruments stay together. But this is Balkanica for bass and tenor trombone. I also want to say that we just found out today rehearsing that Chris Bassett and I might be the last few people on planet Earth who have not been using tablets. this is your inaugural concert with a tablet?
This is the debut.
And this tour is my first use of the tablet. So
we finally made it to the 21st century.
Thank you.
So the next piece on the program is also going to feature some locals, I'll say. Most of you are probably aware, but I'm just going to say it. Dr. Brad Palmer has one of the greatest trombone studios in the world here at Columbus State University. Some of the most gifted and hardworking students I've ever been around. And I teach at a pretty good school. I used to teach at Juilliard. And I'm gonna put his motivation level of his students and what they do and how he runs his studio with any other studio in the world. So we're gonna play a piece. I'm gonna play a piece with him that I had arranged. This is the William Grant Steele Romance, which was written in 1926 for saxophone and piano. And William Grant Steele is considered, or was considered, the dean of African American composers right around the early 20th century in America. He wrote, I want to say, I think he wrote 9 ballets, he wrote 10 operas. He wrote many very popular symphonies. His Afro American Symphony was the theme music for a World's Fair in the early 20th century. Very popular composer. And was considered one of the Harlem Renaissance composers of the early 20th century. This piece, again, I said, was originally written for saxophone. And a few years ago, Mr. Doug Yeo, who was the bass trombonist of the Boston Symphony Orchestra at the time, kind of rediscovered this music and said, hey, I'm going to arrange it for trombone and piano. And then I had the bright idea, hey, I'm going to have this arranged for strings and piano by a British composer by the name of Richard Schofield. I want to make sure I get his name right. Richard Schofield. He arranged this for trombone solo and trombone quartet, and later on, a couple of weeks, I'm going to play it with trombone and strings. So this is the premiere of this particular arrangement of the William Grant Steele Romance. Yeah, you guys are part of the premiere here. So without further ado,
Thank you.
face for sure. We're going to bring out Dr. Chan here. She's going to hear it. Another university that we're visiting, actually in 2 days, actually, is Mercer University, which is very close to here. And Mercer University, the head of the theory department there is a guy named Christopher Allen Schmitz, who was a member of my first trombone studio as a university teacher way back in 1999 at the University of Northern Iowa. And Chris came in as a freshman trombone major and was pretty good and was very ambitious, but had some issues. I was only there for 1 year, but during the course of that year, I told Chris, I said, you gotta change this and that and this, and if you don't, you're probably not gonna be a professional trombone player. And then we lost touch for over a decade. And at some point I was back in this area and I reconnected with Chris Schmitz, and he indeed had stopped playing trombone and had become a composer. And so we talked, and of course I asked him to write a piece for me. And this sonata that you're gonna hear, we've been out here for an hour. Do you wanna do all the movements of this? Let's do the first and the last movement, I guess. We're gonna do the first and last movement of this, because I don't wanna keep us too long here. But we're gonna do the first and last movement of the sonata that Chris and I worked on together. And it has an interesting composition. He had an interesting composition process. He asked me to send him lots of different moments from the Metropolitan Opera that I loved, which I did. I sent him a whole bunch of YouTube videos, and he analyzed the scores and the textures and the melodies, and he kind of infused all of that into this composition, this sonata that he wrote for me. So this is a little bit of the Schmitz sonata. We're not going to play all of it for you tonight because of the additional pieces on our program. But before we play this, I want to say thank you to Dr. Brad Palmer. He's probably out there somewhere. Where is he? Somewhere? There he is. Thank you so much, Brad, for having me back. This feels like home to me. It's such a beautiful hall. It's such a beautiful university. So we'll play the first and second movement of the Schmitz. They're kind of fun. Thank you.
Thank you.